Hi, it's Dibyajyoti Mahapatra. Welcome to my channel, DJM Physics.
Today's topic is Introduction to Gauss Law. But before going to Gauss Law, let us first understand what is a positive flux and what is a negative flux. In the last video or in the last class, we have discussed these two formula for flux, electric flux. We can use flux equal to integration of E vector dot ds vector if the field is non-uniform, and we can use flux equal to E vector dot S vector if the field is uniform one. And if since they are dot product, obviously it can be written as E dot ds or E into ds into cos theta. And the second formula can also be written as E into S into cos theta. Now what is this theta? Angle between what and what? Angle between E vector and the ds vector, or angle between E vector and the S vector, means the area vector and the electric field vector. Now let us take an example. This is an area of any shape, and some electric field lines are passing like this. Okay, some electric field lines are passing like this. Now you choose any area. Okay, let I am choosing an area here, a small area here. As we know that area vector is always perpendicular outward direction. So if I will choose an area vector here, okay, its direction will be like this. So this will be ds vector, and electric field vector is along this direction. So what is the angle between them? 0 degree. So in this case, flux is going to be E dot ds into cos 0 degree, or I can write it as E dot ds. Means you can see that here the flux is going to be positive. Okay, but if I will choose a electric field at this point, through this surface, okay, here the direction of electric field is like this, but the direction of the surface area, the small surface area, let it is some ds2 vector. Okay, in the first surface let it was ds1 vector, and now it is let ds2 vector. Similarly, the electric field is not uniform, so let I am taking it here E1, and here let it as E2. Okay, and now you can see the angle between them is this theta. Okay, the theta is not known in this case actually, but whatever it may be, it must be greater than 90 degree. It is very clear from the diagram that it is greater than 90 degree. Okay, now since it is greater than 90 degree, obviously the cos theta value will be negative. If theta is greater than 90 degree, then obviously cos theta will be negative, and if cos theta negative, then obviously the flux is going to be negative in this case. Okay, you can take any one more example. Let this surface, okay, in this case let this electric field is E3 vector, and the surface area direction will be again perpendicularly outward direction like this. Now you can see this angle theta here, theta is less than 90 degree, and if theta is less than 90 degree, obviously the cos theta is going to be positive, and hence the flux is going to be positive. Okay, so and somewhere you may also get that the angle is 90 degree. Okay, in some cases if the angle is 90 degree, then the flux is going to be zero in that case, as we have shown in the many cases in the last class also. So what I am going to tell here is that flux is positive if the theta value is going to be less than 90 degree. Okay, and flux is negative when the theta value is going to be greater than 90 degree. Okay, we can tell it in some other way, that whatever, when the electric field enters in a surface, okay, enters towards a surface, then it is going to be negative, and when it comes out, then it is going to be positive. Okay, you can check any of these surfaces, any of the surface here through which the electric field is coming out, you will find that the angle must be less than 90 degree. You can see here perpendicular outward direction, here it is 0 degree. You can see here the electric field will perpendicular outward direction, it is again less than 90 degree. But you choose any surface here, okay, like let the surface somewhere is here, the electric field will be, the ds vector, that it is some ds4 vector, it will be like this, and the electric field is like this, let it is some e4 vector. Okay, you can see that the again the angle is greater than 90 degree and the flux is going to be again negative. So you can remember this point like this: for entering electric field lines, flux is negative. Okay, so for these lines the flux is taken as negative, and when the electric field lines are leaving out from a surface like this, okay, for all these electric field lines flux is going to be positive. Okay, so flux can be negative, it can be positive, it can be zero also. When it is zero, when the angle between the electric field line and the flux, electric field line and the area vector is 90 degree, in that case it is going to be zero. Okay, so now let us come to the Gauss law. So here let us come to the most important topic of this chapter, that is Gauss law. First let us come to the definition. The total flux through a closed surface is 1 by epsilon naught times the net charge enclosed by the surface. Okay, so what does that mean? If there is a surface of any shape, remember of any shape, okay, but it must be a closed one, not an open one like a sphere. It is not applicable for a circle, it is for a sphere, like for a cube or for any three dimensional surface. This surface must be a part of a three dimensional object, okay, like a surface of a cube, like the spherical surface of the cylinder, flat surface of the cylinder, like that. Okay, it is not applicable for this type of shape. Okay, so here this shape, remember, flux can be through open surface also, can be through closed surface also, but this Gauss law is only applicable for closed surface. Okay, so let this is a surface, a three dimensional one, you can see only one surface, the upper part let I am seeing. Okay, so inside this, let there are some charges here, let q1 charge here, let q2 charge here, let q3 charge here, let q4 charge, some charge outside also, like that it is given. So this Gauss law tells us that the total flux through this closed surface will be equal to the all the charges inside the surface. Remember, only the net charge enclosed by the surface. What are the charges enclosed here? It is going to be q1 plus, or let it is minus q2. So q1 minus q2 plus q3 divided by epsilon naught. Remember, it has nothing to do with this charge because it is outside the surface. The surface was here, it was outside the surface, so it is not going to be included in this part. The next thing is that you have to calculate the net charge, not by individual charge you cannot calculate, the total charge or the net charge you have to calculate, keeping in mind whether it is positive or negative, that also. Okay, and it is also, it is only applicable for closed surface. So from this definition, if you want to write the mathematical formula, it is going to be flux equal to, or electric flux equal to q inside, means the charges inside the closed surface, divided by epsilon naught. Okay, but Gauss law is not useful in this form, because Gauss law is made, or Gauss law has an application to find the electric field of different charge systems. Okay, so if it is useful for electric field, we have to write a equation in which electric field is included, and we know that already. This was the definition of flux. Yes or no? This is the definition. Remember this part, flux equal to integration of E vector dot ds vector. This part is not the Gauss law. This is the definition of flux, and for this part is the Gauss law. Okay, so if you write the equation like this, you can see there is a electric field and there is charge inside. So if you know the charge inside a surface, a closed surface, then you can also calculate the electric field. And this line is, or this concept is very very useful in the in calculating the electric field. We will see that in later on classes. Okay, but here again there are some important four notes I have made here to remember, and they are must to be remembered. What are they? First point, whatever electric field, whatever charge you have written here, that must be the charges inside the surface. But while calculating the electric field, or while calculating this part, you must have to calculate all the electric field due to all the charges. Okay,
means when I am calculating this part, let for this surface, I have to check the electric field due to this charge, due to this, and also due to this charge. Okay. So, in this expression, in this mathematical expression, this E dot ds must be calculated for all the charges, for all the charges. Okay. And I have given a symbol here like a circle and written S here. What does that represent? This circle, this S represent that we have to do the integration for a surface, and this circle here represent that the surface is a closed surface. Okay, so this symbol represents the closed surface integral. Okay, so that is an important point. Remember the charge when you are calculating the flux by using Gauss law or by using the charges, then you have to only consider the charges inside the surface. But while you are calculating the flux by using the definition, you have to take or you have to consider all the electric field created by all the charges. It may be inside the surface or it may be outside the surface. Now the next point is this. For any medium other than air or vacuum, we can see here that we have used here epsilon naught, okay, which is the permittivity for vacuum or approximately for air also. But if the surface, inside the surface, the medium is not air, okay, or not vacuum, then we can replace this epsilon naught by epsilon. As we know, this is the permittivity of any other medium. And this can also be written as like this, epsilon r into epsilon naught. Why? Because we know epsilon or permittivity, can relative permittivity epsilon r can be written as epsilon by epsilon naught, where epsilon r is relative permittivity, epsilon is permittivity of the given medium, epsilon naught is the permittivity of vacuum. So, from here epsilon equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r. So, this also can be written, and in some books this epsilon r can may have represented with k also. In some books they are representing this epsilon r relative permittivity with the value of, with the symbol k, because k actually represents dielectric constant, okay, and they both are approximately the same meaning. Okay, we will come across that k dielectric constant in the next chapter while studying about the capacitance and all. Okay, now the third point, Gauss law is applicable to any kind of closed surface. Remember, it is not applicable only for regular surfaces like cube and sphere and not like that. It is applicable for any kind of surface you may take, any arbitrary surface like this also if you will take, that for that also it is applicable, but it must be a closed one, not a two-dimensional one, it must be a closed one. Okay. And the last and the most important point is that the flux does not depend upon the size, shape and position of the charges inside the surface until the charge enclosed is unchanged. What does that mean? It means let there is a surface like this, okay, or let there is a sphere, okay, let there is a sphere inside which there is a charge q is there here, okay, and someone is going to ask that what will be the flux, and if it is q, then what will be the flux here? Q by epsilon naught, okay, initial flux. Now if someone is asking you, I am converting the sphere into a cylinder. Okay, let this sphere is converted into a cylindrical one, then what will be the flux to the cylinder? Answer is going to be same, because you can see in the definition there is nothing to do with the shape or size. Okay, similarly if someone will ask, I have increased the volume of the sphere, I have made a larger sphere, but the charge enclosed is the same q, then what will be the flux? Again the answer is going to be q by epsilon naught, because it does not depend upon the size also. Similarly, if someone will ask, the charge is here, what will be the flux? And if I will move the charge to here, how the flux will change? Answer is no change, because the charge enclosed is not going to change. Here also it was q. If we place here also, it is going to be q. The charge place does not affect the value of the flux. So, it is written here that it does not depend upon size, shape or the position of the charge, unless and until the charge enclosed by the surface is same. Okay, if the charge enclosed is same, then it does not depend upon the size, shape or the position of the charge to find the flux. Okay, now let us come to
some numericals, some easier to some tricky one to understand this concept clearly. Now example one, let it is given that inside a sphere there are two dipoles are kept. Okay, it is given that there are two dipoles are given kept and its charges are also given, and it sometimes it gives its dipole moment, its this length, the radius of the sphere and like that also it may have given, and is asking what is the flux through it. Okay, so what will be the answer? If you have understood the definition, then what is the flux? Flux will be equal to Q inside, the net charge inside divided by epsilon naught. Okay, now what is the net charge? If this is a dipole, here let the charge is Q minus Q, then here the charge is going to be plus Q. Here the charge may be minus Q dash and here it is going to be plus Q dash. Okay, what is the net charge inside the sphere now? Zero, because minus Q plus Q zero, minus Q dash plus Q dash zero, and it is going to be zero by epsilon naught, or the answer is going to be zero. So whenever you keep some dipoles inside some closed surface, whatever its dipole moment may be, whatever the shape of the surface may be, if it is a closed surface, then its net charge or net flux through the surface is always going to be zero, because the net charge is zero. Now let us take another example. There is an hemispherical sphere is given. What is given? Hemispherical. Remember, not semicircular. It is hemispherical sphere. Okay, and a charge Q is placed at the center of the hemispherical sphere. It is asked what is the flux through the hemispherical sphere. Now, if you have understood clearly, hemispherical sphere, in hemispherical sphere you cannot use Gauss law. Why? Because Gauss law can only be useful in closed surface, and an hemisphere is never closed, it is open on this side. Okay, so in that case, and this charge is kept at the flat surface, center of the flat surface, then in that case what you can do? First let us assume a closed surface which is surrounding this charge symmetrically. Remember, what you have to assume? First you have to assume a closed surface surrounding the given charge symmetrically. Now why it is symmetrical needed, I am just coming to that point. Okay, so first thing, closed surface, and second thing, the surface that this charge should be closed by the surface symmetrically. Now how we can make that? Let us complete this hemisphere as a sphere. Okay, now if it is a sphere and this charge is now at the center of the sphere, now from this charge everywhere the electric field lines are coming. Okay, and as we know the properties of the electric field line, they will move symmetrically everywhere in all the direction, they will be radially outward for a single point charge. Okay, now obviously it means whatever charge, whatever electric field line or the number of field line passing through this upward upside hemisphere, the same electric field line will pass through the bottom hemisphere. Okay, means if the flux through the upper hemisphere is let flux or phi dash, the bottom also, through the bottom also the flux will be phi dash. Okay, because it depends upon the number of field lines, and since it is a charge which is symmetrically surrounded by a sphere, okay, then obviously in the upside hemisphere the flux will be phi dash, and in the downside hemisphere also the flux will be phi dash. Now what is the total flux? What is the total flux through the sphere? Total flux to the sphere is phi. That will be equal to phi dash plus phi dash, or equal to 2 phi dash. Okay, but we know what is this value is going to be. Now it is a sphere inside which there is a charge Q, and what is the value of flux in that case? According to Gauss law, it is going to, this flux is going to be Q by epsilon naught. So we got Q by epsilon naught equal to 2 phi dash, and hence phi dash will be equal to Q by 2 epsilon naught. So this is the answer. Is it clear to everyone? So what we have done, वी हैव अज्यूम्ड ए क्लोज सरफेस. इफ इट इज अ क्लोज सरफेस ऑलरेडी देन इट्स ओके, डायरेक्टली यूज अ फॉर्मूला. इफ इट इज नॉट ए क्लोज सरफेस, इनिशियली इट वॉज गिवेन एज अ हेमीस्फियर. ओके, सो वी हैव टू अज्यूम ए स्पीयर फास्ट. ओके, व्हाई ए स्पीयर ओनली? ओके, लेट मी अगेन टेल यू व्हाई ए स्पीयर ओनली. इफ इट इज ए सरफेस एन हेमीस्फियर, आई कैन अज्यूम लाइक दिस ऑल्सो. व्हाई ए स्पीयर ओनली? नाउ ऑल्सो इट इज क्लोज, इट इज ए थ्री डायमेंशनल सर्फेस, नाउ इट इज ऑल्सो क्लोज. बट इन दैट केस इफ दिस इज गोइंग टू बी फाइव डेज, इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी फाइव डेज, इट विल बी गोइंग टू बी सम फाइव डबल डेज. दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू सेम. ओके, एंड इफ दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू सेम, देन ऑब्वियसली द इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स थ्रू दिस एंड थ्रू दिस आर नॉट गोइंग टू बी सेम. ओके, सो यू कैन नॉट राइट इट इज टू फाइव डेज लाइक दैट. ओके, सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट व्हाट एवर सरफेस यू आर अज्यूमिंग, एंड लेट मी टेल यू दैट दिस अज्यूम सरफेस, this total assumed surface is known as Gaussian surface. What is it known as? Gaussian surface. We'll come to this term later on also, but for now let me just introduce this term. This total surface which is surrounding the given charge is also known as Gaussian surface, and it is a imaginary one. This one was not given, this you have imagined. Okay, so this total closed surface is known as a Gaussian surface. We'll come to this term later on also. Is it clear how to find? Now let us come to the next example. Now let this is some kind of matka, like a mod utensil in which you keep water. Okay, so it is a complete one sphere one, but at the top side it is open. Okay, and at the center of that part a Q charge is kept. Okay, where it is kept? There is a open matka is there. Okay, nearby this open space there is a charge Q kept at this point, center of this point. Okay, like this, and it is asked what is the flux through this surface. Now again it is not a closed one because it is open here, so the same method we have to assume a surface, or first make it a closed surface such that this charge will be symmetrically surrounded by the closed surface. So what we have to do? Just imagine the same shape kept inverted at this point, means like this. Okay, same kind of a matka, but it is kept inverted here. Okay, now you can see that this charge is surrounded by a symmetrical object. You can see whatever shape is there at the top side, the same shape is there at the bottom side. Okay, so what will be the total flux? Let the flux through this part is 5s, let the flux through this part is 5s. Okay, what is the total flux through this closed surface? It is again going to be phi, that will be equal to q by epsilon naught. Okay, and also phi will be equal to addition of these two flux, that is a scalar, so it is 5s plus 5s or equal to 2 5s. Now using these two equation I can write q by epsilon naught equal to 2 phi dash, and hence phi dash equal to q by 2 epsilon naught again. Okay, so the method is same, and remember it is not always going to be q by 2 epsilon naught. By chance in the last two example it came q by 2 epsilon. Now, this is the next question. There is a square is given of each side A, and a charge is kept at a height of a by 2 from the center of the square. We have to find the flux through this square. Okay, so let this is a square, let this is a square. Okay, I am, and this is the center of the square. Center means cross section of the two diagonals. No, the charge is not kept here, the charge is kept above this at a height of a by 2. If this side, each side is a, then this charge is kept from above the surface at a height of a by 2. We have to find the flux through this surface. Okay, now again this is not a closed surface, so we have to assume a closed surface surrounding this charge here symmetrically. And how we can do that? Let us assume a cube. Okay, just a minute, I will just represent the same question in this diagram. Let here why a cube, that answer is not direct one. You have to use your brain to find what shape you are going to take. Okay, now let this surface is this one. I am talking about this one. Okay, each side of A being A. And it is, and if this is A, obviously this height is going to be A because it is a cube, and at the center, okay, the center will be just at a height of A by 2 from the origin, from the center of this surface. Is it clear? So I can assume that there is a cube and a charge Q is placed at the center of the cube. Okay, and I have to find the surface, I have to find the flux through this surface, this one surface. Is it clear? Now, can you imagine that this question and this question are exactly same? If you keep a charge Q at the center of a cube having as each side as A, then it is exactly same as this question. You are keeping a charge Q at a height of A by 2 because obviously the center will be at a height of A by 2 from this plane, because this total height is A, so this height is going to be A by 2. Now, what is the total flux through this one? Let that is phi, and phi will be given by Q by epsilon naught. Total flux through all the surfaces. Now, here there are no two surfaces. How many surfaces are there? Left hand side, right hand side, up, down, back side and front side. So, total 6 surfaces. So, for each surface, let for this surface, the flux is phi dash. So, for each surface, the flux will be phi dash because now the charge is symmetrically surrounded. So, I can write that here flux can be written as 6 phi dash. Okay? Phi dash, phi dash, phi dash, phi dash, like that through each surface. It is, if it is phi dash, then the total flux will be equal to 6 phi dash. So, from these two equations, I can write phi dash or 6 phi dash will be equal to Q by epsilon naught, and hence phi dash will be equal to Q by 6 epsilon naught. Is it clear? Now, you can see if the question is like this initially, if let forget this question, let initially the question is like this, what will be the flux through each surface of a cube where the charge is kept at the center of the cube, then the question will be very easy. You don't have to imagine anything because it is already a closed surface given, just find it. But this question may be taken a step forward like this. Okay, if this is the question, then you have to use your brain to assume that this question can also be represented like this, then you can find your answer. Okay. Now, let us come to the next question. Again, a same type of question, that if this is a charge cube placed at the center of the of a cylinder, flat surface of a cylinder having a length L and cross sectional area A, then find the flux through this cylinder. Okay. Now, again, this charge, although this is a closed surface, this charge is not surrounded by a closed surface because it is at the top. If it is at the center, then I can tell, okay, this is surrounded by a closed one. But now it is not surrounded by a closed one. Okay, it is at the top of a cylinder. If this is a cylinder, it is at this point. Okay, so below it there is a closed surface, but above it there is not a closed surface. So this charge is not surrounded symmetrically by a closed surface. Is it clear? Remember that this given structure is a closed one. Okay. But here how the flux will come? Like this, the electric field lines will be like this, but not only like this, the field lines also will go like this, okay, in all the directions. So if the question was like this, that the charge Q at this place, then obviously the flux is, you can directly tell it is Q by epsilon naught. But in this case, what you have to assume? Again, you have to assume a structure which surrounds this with a symmetric manner, like this. What I have assumed? We have assumed another cylinder just above it, okay, of the same length. Okay, the length is exactly same, and the cross sectional area is obviously going to be same. Now you can tell again the same thing. For this, let the flux is phi dash. Through this, let the flux is phi dash. Okay, so I can tell that total phi will be equal to 2 phi dash will be equal to q by epsilon naught, and hence phi dash will be equal to q by 2 epsilon naught. Okay. Now, this type of questions, this type of shape may become like there is a charge at the flat surface, at the center of a flat surface of a cone. What will be the flux? Again, you can do the same thing. What you can do, you just keep a another cone of the same height and same same radius, and you can again find that the answer will be equal to q by 2 epsilon dot. Okay. Now, let us come to some other type of questions like this. There is a charge kept at this point, at the center of the one side of this cube. It is now asked what is the flux through its surface. Now see, this question will be very easy if the charge will kept at the center. But now this charge is not kept at the center, it is kept at this side, at the center of or at the midpoint of this side, one of its side. Okay. Now you have to surround this structure or this charge by symmetric structures. Okay. Again, remember those symmetric structures by using which you are going to surround this charge, they must be similar like this. Then only you can tell that through each of that structure the same flux is going to come. Like here, if it is a cylinder and I will assume a cone here, the charge is surrounded by a closed surface but not symmetrically. Similarly, since it is a cube, we have to place some other cubes around this charge such that it will be surrounded symmetrically by all the cubes, and this charge will be closed or this charge will be placed at the center of the total structure that we have assumed. Okay. So, for that, what you can do? You can now you have to imagine it, because it is a complete three-dimensional structure and very difficult to draw it here actually. Let me just try if I can. Okay. So, I have placed another cube here of the same shape, same size, okay, where just if this is a cube, if this is a cube and this is the last side, I have just kept another cube here. Okay. Now, you can see that it is surrounded, not surrounded symmetrically, because these two cubes are just back side of this charge. Now, you have to keep again two cubes just above here, one cube here. Okay, above in front of this, and one cube here in front of this cube. Okay, this you have to imagine, this cannot be drawn on the paper. Okay, so now if you will keep four cubes like that, 1, 2, 3, third is on this cube, this surface, and fourth is placed on this surface. Okay, now you can see that all these four cubes are going to the total structure. Now forget about each cube. Now you imagine that total structure made up of four cubes. Now you can see that this charge q is placed at the center of all the four cubes, or all the structure that is made of all the four cubes. Okay. So here I can write that 4 phi dash, let the flux through each flux is going to be phi dash, because there are all the four are cubes, all the four are cubes, which is surrounded by this, which surrounds this charge symmetrically. So, for each cube, if the flux is phi dash, all the four from all the cubes, the flux will be again phi dash, phi dash, and phi dash. So, the total flux is going to be 4 phi dash. Let I am writing it as flux phi. Phi is the total flux through the total 4 cubes. So, phi will be equal to 4 phi dash will be equal to q by epsilon naught, because if it is here, there is a shape made up of 4 cubes, then the total charge, total flux will be equal to q by epsilon naught, and hence flux dash or phi dash will be equal to q by 4 epsilon naught. Okay. Now, there is an exactly similar kind of question I can give as your task. This is your home task or homework, that if a charge q is placed at one of the corners, let here there is a charge q. Okay, yes, cube is given, and at one of the vertices or at one of the corner, the charge q is there. Now find the flux through this surface. Okay, this is your homework, and these are not all the questions regarding the flux. In some questions, it may ask you to find the flux by not from the definition of Gauss law. It may ask you from the from the definition of flux itself, that flux equal to integration of E dot ds and like that. Okay, so these are the basic questions will come in board exam. We will discuss some more questions which is some higher order thinking skills, or you can tell they may come in JEE Main or in NEET exam in the next video. Thank you.